Hello, everybody. My name is Lindsay, and I am the food and nutrition tutor here at Glendale Community College. I also work for Cengage as the student ambassador. So I've made this little tutorial for you today to help you navigate from Canvas to MindTap. So first things first, you gotta pick a web browser. Pick something aside from Internet Explorer. Internet Explorer will not work well with MindTap. So pick something like Safari or Google Chrome or even Mozilla. Any of those will work just fine. Today I'm going to launch Google Chrome. And here I am at mymaricopa.edu, and this is where I can find the Canvas app. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that and log into Canvas, and then I'm going to look over here to the left side of the screen and find courses. I'm going to select that, and I'm going to pick the course that requires me to use MindTap. So for me, that's this course right here. Okay, and the next thing you're going to do is click on Modules. And Modules is where you're going to find the link to get to MindTap. This link will work right here, and this link will also work down here, Diet and Wellness Plus Track Diet. So I'm going to go ahead and click on one of those links, and then I need to click on this to load it in a separate window. And this is the way you're going to do it every time you need to get to MindTap. So here we are. MindTap. On this side is the course overview, and it goes through the book chapter by chapter with the titles of what you're going to study. Okay, and over here to the right of the screen is probably where you're going to spend most of your time. I want to bring your attention to this little green apple over here. This is Diet and Wellness Plus. When you click on this, this is where you're going to go to track your diet and make reports. Okay? So this little green apple is Diet and Wellness. Now I also want to bring your attention to a few other little apps here. Just beneath the apple is this little textbook. This is the full digital textbook. This is kind of handy to have. Okay, if you click on chapters in the upper right corner, it's going to take you to an overview of that whole chapter, and you can skip to any part of the book that you want, or you could read it front to back. I also want to bring your attention to these two little apps. So here's the glossary. This is pretty handy. Okay, you can look up certain terms through here. And you can also use the Merriam-Webster dictionary. Both of these are really cool tools that are nice alternatives to Googling answers. I would highly recommend this over Google any day. Also, this little search key is kind of nice to have. You could look up specific terms and it'll pull up everywhere in the book that that term is mentioned. So that's kind of handy. Well, that's all I have for you in this video. Thanks for watching.